What is up, you guys, and welcome back to my channel. I know it has been so long. I feel like I say that every time I start filming, but literally it's been a hot minute since I posted a video. But this is kind of just like a life update for you guys. A lot has happened in the last 2 months. It's going on 2 months. Today is the 12th. It's going on 2 months and I'm looking a hot mess right now, but this is literally me like 95% of the time, like at home in hoodies on my bed. And I was honestly gonna get ready to go to sleep, but I was like, let me just film something. I need to get everything kind of just clear and like lay everything on the table for you guys, because I don't want to leave you guys in the dark. I'm not like that. So the background and everything is different because I, like I said, I was about to go to sleep, but I was like, you know what, let me just film this life update for you guys. But if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe down below if you are new, so you won't miss any future videos. And yeah, let's just go ahead and get into it. So obviously the first thing you guys are thinking, you're like, what the fuck happened to her eye? That actually is looking horrible now that I like see it. Like, I literally look dead. Oh my god, like I have been getting no sleep. So we're just gonna start from like the very beginning because I don't want to get thrown off track here. When was the last time I posted a video? I think it was like December 20th, if I'm not mistaken. It was a winter makeup tutorial, so yeah, I think it was December 20th. But let me just start from the beginning of December because a lot has happened. Like, literally my life has just been like a roller coaster. Like, it's been going up and down, happy, sad, good, bad. It's just like, it's literally just been a mess. So let's just start from the beginning of December. Basically the beginning of December was a really exciting like few days, because in the first few days of December I actually finally got a car. And those of you guys who know me, you guys know that I've been wanting a car for so long. I've been needing a car, and you know, I've been car hunting and like car hunting. Is that even a thing? I've been looking for cars, and like I was just like looking nonstop, and I just didn't know really what I wanted, because at first I wanted a Nissan, then I wanted a Honda, then I wanted a Jeep, then I wanted a Mercedes. I just like, I started, you know, just going crazy. Like when I first learned how to drive, I was like, I want this, I want that, I want this. But you know, as you get older, like once you start looking for cars, you're like, okay, I need to figure out, does it ride smooth? I need to figure out how much gas, I need to figure out basically how much the repairs cost for when, you know, damages happen. Because let me tell you guys, foreign cars are expensive AF to fix. I ended up getting a car, and shout out to my parents for helping me out, because I couldn't have done it without them. And yeah, I got a Nissan Maxima, a 2011 Nissan Maxima Sport. And it's crazy because that was like my very first option when looking for a car. I was like, I want a Nissan Maxima. But then like I had seen the Sport Edition and I was like, oh my god, it's gorgeous. But I was just super excited. I had started off the last month of 2018 in the best way possible. So obviously weeks passed, and the 20th I uploaded my only winter tutorial, and that's because a lot, like I said, a lot has happened. I don't really want to veer off track, so we're going to go ahead and fast forward. On December 21st, which was a Friday, I went out on Friday night and I got a phone call from my mom, and she was saying that my dog, you know, well, she was sick, she didn't look like she was feeling good. And that morning she woke up really sick. For those of you who don't know, I have a dog and she is a Chihuahua. Her name is Tinkerbell. I will insert pictures here. And there was, I think, 2-3 videos that she came out in and made her debut on my YouTube channel. She woke up sick, and I still went out that night because I didn't really think anything of it. Like, you know, she has gotten sick before, but it wasn't like the same type of sick, I guess you can say. So when I got home, I got home around like 2 in the morning Saturday, and she still was awake. She wasn't getting enough sleep and she was very dehydrated. She wasn't eating, she wasn't drinking, and she couldn't really hold in her bathroom problem, I guess you can say. I don't want her like, oh, she really couldn't hold it in, because she was at an old age. So we had to also lay out like these mats because she couldn't hold it in anymore to use the restroom. So on Saturday, I had, early morning Saturday, I had booked some people to do their makeup, you know, some clients. I had to cancel on everybody that day, just because she woke up even worse. Like, she just, like, she had the runs. She just, it was just a mess. So that's when I told my dad, you know what, we have to take her to the ER. So we took her to an ER, a pet hospital in Berkeley. And basically, you know, we took her on her bed. So it was like, let me just use the example. Her bed was like this big. So I had her on my lap the whole ride, like the whole car ride. And it was just kind of like, it was kind of weird seeing her in that state. I mean, like, I had always seen her so happy, seen her so energetic, even at her age, you know? She was super sick, and I rode the whole way there with her, and we walked her in, and that's, like, pet hospitals and clinics and vets are, you know, like, on leash only, I guess, for, like, pets. And we walked her in on a bed, and everybody was like, oh, like, everybody who worked there was asking, oh, is she gonna be okay? What's gonna happen? Or, like, is she okay in the bed? You know, is she gonna jump out? I said, no, she's not gonna jump out. She has no energy. She was, at that point, she was drained from her energy. We checked her in, and they took her back to take her vitals. And with every other dog that was there, it's safe to say that with every nurse that took the dog back to take their vitals, the dog came back out with them. And they all started the conversation, or, like, they all started, like, the sentence with, oh, their vitals are looking good, right? So the nurse who took Tinkerbell in came back by herself. She didn't have Tinkerbell, she didn't have her bed, and she didn't start with her vitals are good. And I was like, something is wrong. So she had came out, and she was like, well, so we're keeping her back there so we can keep an eye on her. Yeah, so I want to say, like, an hour passed, and I was sitting in the waiting room, and my dad was with me for, like, I want to say half an hour, until he had to go run an errand for work. So he was like, I'll be right back. So while my dad was gone, they actually called me back, and they sat me in a room, and I was by myself. Keep in mind, it was, like, a nurse, the actual vet, and then myself. And they sat me down, and they were like, okay, so here's what's going on with Tinkerbell. She has a few things wrong. And I was just like, that's not what I want to hear. So basically, they were explaining that Tinkerbell had a heart murmur, but they didn't know how severe it was because they weren't her usual vet. Mind you, she didn't really have a set vet because she never got sick on us, like, at all. So she had a heart murmur. Whether it was severe, whether it was developing, it was there. And then she also had a pyometra. Pyometra is basically an infection in the uterus. And there are two types of pyometras. There's an open pyometra and a closed pyometra. And I guess the closed pyometra is worse. So Tinkerbell's was an open pyometra, which means her uterus was leaking pus. And I didn't notice that it was leaking pus until on the ride to the ER. So they were like, well, the good thing is that she has an open pyometra, because if it was a closed pyometra, the pus would be leaking into the organs and basically cause an infection. So basically, she had an open pyometra, and that requires surgery because it is an infection and it can get worse. So they were saying that in order to do that surgery, they offered the surgery there, but it was $6,000 to $7,000 because they were an emergency room. And I was like, holy crap, like, we don't have that money. So then they mentioned, oh, what we can do is we can suggest or recommend a low-cost clinic, which would do it for around $600 to $700. I was just like, you know what, that's, like, still so much. They were like, or you can choose to euthanize her. And I was just like, why would I do that? They explained, well, the reason being is because of her age, because she was 14 going on 15 years old, human years. They didn't know if she was going to react well to the anesthetics. They didn't know if she was going to make it through the surgery. They didn't know if she was going to make it after the surgery, meaning during the recovery, like, literally a day or so after. They didn't know if she was going to make it through. And they were like, euthanizing her would probably be the best option. So in my head, I'm thinking, why would I want my parents and I to spend this much money on her surgery if there's, like, a huge possibility because of her age that she's not going to make it through the surgery? Like, I would rather be with her while she gets euthanized versus, you know, her, like, passing away alone on a table. So while all this was being thrown at me, I literally started bawling. I lost my shit. Like, I literally just, it just felt different. Like, you don't ever imagine, like, going through that until you actually go through that. So it was just the worst experience ever. I was alone. I called my mom. I called my dad. My dad said, I'll be on my way. My mom said, oh my God, did you call your dad? Like, it was just, it was a lot. It was a lot. So I waited for my dad and they just gave me some tissues and they were like, you can just think about it. They left me alone. My dad got there and I told my dad, I want to euthanize her. And my dad was like, are you sure? And I was like, honestly, like, I explained to him, like, I don't want her to die alone. I don't want her to not be strong enough to make it through. I didn't want her to suffer. And we made that decision. So they gave us the antibiotics to bring home with her for that night so she can get through the night at least, because she was scheduled the next morning to be euthanized. We brought her home and I didn't leave her side. My brother didn't leave her side. And it just felt like different. I don't know how to explain it. It felt like one of the worst feelings I had ever felt, because I literally felt like her life is literally in my hands. And how is this possible if I'm not even the one performing the surgery? I'm not even the one going through all of this pain like she is. And it sucked. So I slept with her, but I literally didn't get any sleep. I got like 2 hours of sleep because I couldn't sleep. I literally felt like I got no sleep. Like I just shut my eyes for like 30 seconds and that was it. Like, that's literally how it felt. Next morning, my dad and my mom and myself were talking and we were like, you know what? Like, she's a strong dog. You know, I would rather pay for the surgery than feel like, what if this, what if that, all these what ifs, and like not give her a fighting chance. So we were all for it, you know. We were like, you know, if it's coming from them, because I would never be the one to push them to spend that money, but you know, if it was coming from them, so we decided to go through with it. We called the ER. We were like, can we get a hold of the low-cost clinic because we want to go through the surgery. So they sent us to the low-cost clinic, which was actually super local to our house, and we went, we took her in, and they were saying she looks really weak. She hasn't eaten, she hasn't slept, she hasn't drank any water. So we don't know if we can even perform the surgery. And we're like, there goes that idea. Like, great. And then they were like, we can put her on some IV fluids and then we'll see how she reacts to those. And then if we see that she's doing okay, we'll perform the surgery. So we left her there for 2 hours. And it literally, I kid you not, like every 15-20 minutes I was calling, how is she doing, is she okay, like what's going on. I finally called again and they were like, you know what, she's doing pretty okay with the IV, we're gonna go ahead and go through with the surgery. So they performed the surgery. It took about 2 hours. They called me, they said she'll be ready soon for pickup, can you be here at so and so time. So I was like, you know, of course, like I will be there. So we went, we picked her up, and she wasn't really responsive to them until we got there and we called her name and, you know, we're talking to her, and she was more attentive. Like, her ears, you know, her little chihuahua ears just kind of like went up. She was super attentive. She was still kind of out of it because of the anesthetics. When we picked her up, the doctor or the surgeon that performed her surgery said, basically, we think that it's probably best, like, it's just their recommendation. They were like, it's probably best that we have you take her back to the ER in Berkeley. So they can keep an eye on her overnight because we still don't know how she's going to make it through the night. And I was like, I didn't want to leave her. I didn't want to leave her. I was like, I just got her back and I'm already going to go drop her off somewhere else. Like, how does this even work, you know? Yeah, we brought her home for literally like 5 minutes and then we took her back. And I literally remember just looking at her and just like praying, like, please make it through the night. Like, so, they had told us, they were like, you can pick her up at 7 a.m. Mind you, this surgery happened on Sunday. 7 a.m. was Christmas Eve. 7 a.m. Christmas Eve, the 24th. You guys can pick her up at 7 a.m. if she makes it through. And we were just getting all these mixed signals. The doctor who came in to speak to us was like, we don't know if she's going to be okay. You know, she should be fine, but we're not sure. The nurse who came in was like, oh yeah, I don't see why not. I don't see why she's not going to be fine. And stuff like that. So we were just kind of getting these mixed signals and we just basically prayed on it several times in the night. I came home, I kind of just wanted to keep my mind busy, so I started making Christmas cookies and I started, you know, just making all these treats and stuff because I had family coming over the next day and I knew the kitchen was going to be super full. So I just put myself to work pretty much. And by the time I called the first time to check on her, it was about, I want to say 10:30, 11 at night, the night before Christmas Eve. And I called and they were like, you know what, she's doing okay, we're still keeping an eye on her. Mind you, I was there when they placed her into the little cage because they're basically like little kennels in the back. And she was the oldest dog there. And I remember just standing by her and just had my forehead on her forehead. And I just couldn't leave her. Every time I stepped back, she'd get up and she'd look around, but she wasn't really looking. So, so they were like, you know what, she's doing okay. You know, hopefully she'll get better. She hasn't eaten or anything. So then I called again like at 12:30 and they were like, oh yeah, she's doing great. Like, she just ate for us. She ate some wet dog food, like some soaked dog food. She ate some baby food happily for us and she's doing okay. I was like, thank God. I just like prayed on it. I was like, thank you, Lord. Just thank you, right? So fast forward to about like 2 a.m. I called again because I was about to go to sleep and I was like, you know, let me just call one more time because I just want to make sure. So I called and they had me on hold for like, I want to say 4 or 5 minutes, and they hadn't had me on hold at all that night. So I knew in my gut, like I felt, I was like, something's wrong. And I spoke with a guy, with a male worker, the first time when they put me on hold. And then as soon as they took me off hold, it was a female worker. So I'm like, oh great, like he couldn't even have the nerve to tell me, like someone else had to tell him or someone else had to help him tell me. And yeah, she was like, hi. She's like, is this Tinkerbell's owner? And I was like, yeah. And she was like, okay. She's like, I just wanted to inform you that unfortunately she didn't make it through. And I'm sitting there and I'm like, I didn't know what to say. I literally felt like, I was in the kitchen, I was cleaning up, I literally had the phone to my ear and I literally just like dropped myself and I just crouched down and I started bawling. I literally, oh my goodness. The first thing I did was call my dad, and he worked overnight, and I was like, you know what, like she didn't make it. He left early, he came to pick us up, and we drove out there, and they were like, you know, they said, do you want to see her? It took us an hour to like get our stuff together and go see her. So I walked in and I was like, it was a sucky feeling. I mean, knowing I was gonna walk in and then walk out without her. We walked in and took us to a room and they brought her in her bed that we dropped her off in, and she literally was like so stiff, like I don't know how to explain it. She was just super stiff and cold. Like, I don't know. Literally haven't talked about this in a hot second. Like, I just remember there was like, in the room, there was like a bench against the wall. So the bench and then the door and, you know, it's just the wall pretty much. My mom sat down in the corner. My sister sat down next to her. I sat down and then my other sister in the other corner. And then my dad was just standing by the wall. So they brought her in and they put her down and none of us got close, really. We didn't know what to really, like, do. So my mom was first and she grabbed the bed and she was like, Daddy, do you want to see her? And I was like, no, like, I literally just sat there like bawling silently. Like, I just like, I was like this and I was like this and I was just like covering my face and I just wanted to be with myself. And until like they finally like passed her bed over, and I was just looking at her. I just remember staring at her. Like, it was a lot because literally hours before we had left her there to be observed, to be watched over, I was just like, I didn't know what to think. So that night, my dad was like, before we left, he was like, do you want her collar? And I was like, yeah, like, I'll take her collar. So to this day, the collar, I have it hanging from my rear view mirror in my car. We came home around 6 a.m. I think I want to say 6 a.m. And I only slept until 10. So I only got 4 hours of sleep, and I woke up. And the first thing I did when I woke up was literally pack everything up. Like, I folded all her blankets. She had two different beds, so I put both beds away. Put her shampoos. I literally have a container, and I just labeled it Tink. And I just have everything put away. All her little outfits that I would buy her and everything. I put it all away. The next morning, I didn't talk to anybody. I was super quiet, and I think we were all kind of just like in shock. So we were all super just mellow, I guess. Everybody kept saying, I'm so sorry for your loss, I'm sorry for your loss, like, and it just like, it didn't click. Like, I mean, I was trying to kind of forget about it, but it didn't click until weeks passed after that. I'm actually gonna, like, towards the end of this video, I'm gonna post like clips, because I did try. I promise you guys, I tried everything to bring myself to vlog on Christmas Eve, because a lot of my family came over who don't usually come over anymore or as often. So I tried to vlog my best, and I literally barely got any footage because I just couldn't bring myself to just hold the camera. I haven't been able to put myself in front of a camera in so long. So towards the end of the video, I'll just post any clips that I have with like the dates and everything. And yeah, basically a few weeks passed, and it didn't click until they called, and they were like, you know what, like, her ashes are ready, because we did have her cremated. So they called us, and I went to go pick up her ashes, and I hadn't been there since that night. So this, mind you, this was 2 days after my birthday. So my birthday just passed. I'm a January 2nd baby, and I just turned 20. And 2 days after my birthday, I went to go pick up her ashes. And I was, like, walking out, and they put her ashes in, like, a little cedar box. And, you know, they put a little plaque with her name on it, and they put it in a paper bag with, like, a condolences card and everything. And I was just holding a little paper bag, and I was walking out, and I was just all quiet. And, you know, everybody was like, what's wrong? And I was like, nothing. It's just crazy to me that, like, I'm walking out of where I left her last with nothing but a little box. Like, it was just insane to me. So, with that being said, before I move on to the rest of this life update video, I just want to insert a little clip in here to kind of just give you guys kind of like a little bit of insight on what it was like having her around for 14 years, because that was like my best friend. Like, I think I kind of like took it for granted in a way. I kind of like took her being here still at that age for granted, because my mom and my dad would always tell me, like, you know what, like, she's not gonna be around for long, you know, her age and this and that. And I was like, you know what, like, you guys are like being silly, like, bro, like, come on now, she's Tinkerbell, she's been through so much. So I feel bad in a way that I took it for granted, but I'm so thankful that I had her for these 14 years. She would have been 15 in April. But yeah, I just want you guys to just kind of watch this little clip, and I hope it gives you guys some insight on what it was like to have Tinkerbell.
Call her. Call her, Tinkerbell. 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 She's gonna bite your ear. Lay down with her.
Huda. Huda tikubio. Huda tikubio. Huda tikubio. Oh.
Now to the next few weeks after that, it was by the time I picked up her ashes, it was already January. Like I said before, my birthday passed, so I will just like insert pictures here and there, like right here. I didn't really do anything for my birthday. I stayed home. We bought pizza. I did get ready, but I literally just stayed home and took pictures with my balloons, and it felt good to kind of just be like surrounded by a few of my loved ones and like not be super extravagant. Like I said, it was just everything was still fresh. I wasn't in the mood to do anything, so yeah, that happened. Let's fast forward to mid to late January, so January 24th, which is insane to me, you guys. Okay, it's crazy. Sorry if I'm getting a little monotoned. It's like 1 a.m. and a lot of people are asleep in my house. But on January 24th, my uncle came across these two puppies and he took them in, but he obviously couldn't keep them, but he knew we had just lost Tinkerbell. I didn't want any puppies after we lost Tinkerbell. I didn't want to take that next step into getting another puppy just yet. I just wasn't ready. I was not ready. So my uncle found this puppy on January 24th and he brought him to the house. He was wrapped in a little blanket. It was a boy, and I kid you guys not, the color of this dog looked spot on like Tinkerbell, and I automatically said I want it. They were so small that I had to bottle feed them, okay, them, because later on he mentioned that there was two, and I said there's two, and he's like, yeah, they're brothers. I said, where's the other one? He's like, I left it over there. I said, okay, then go get him and bring him over here. Like, why would you leave him by himself? So we took them both in, and at first we were like, you know what, we're just gonna feed them for a little bit, kind of get them growing, kind of get them going, you know, we're just gonna see how that goes, and then we'll decide if we want to keep them, if we want to keep one, if we want to keep two. But there were just two of them. Their mom was a Chihuahua. We don't know what their dad is, so we don't know if they're mixed or if they're purebred Chihuahua. They look purebred. I will insert pictures right here. This is when I realized that I had no good pictures, so here's a quick video.
No, you're too big. You're too big. Be nice. Be nice. Be nice.
To this day, they are growing so, so fast. We named them. We wanted to keep the names in the Disney family. We had originally gone with Timon and Pumbaa because there was a small little runt, like the runt of the little litter, and then there was the older one who was a little more chunky. So we were like, okay, cool, Timon and Pumbaa, like, automatically, right? But then I remembered that Brother Bear was a movie, and I put it on my Instagram for all of my followers to really just help with the name picking. And a lot of people actually said that the names from Brother Bear fit them best, and they did. They look a lot like them. So I'll post a picture right here of Kenai and Coda, which are the Brother Bears from the movie Brother Bear, and I'll post a picture of the pups here. So there is a pretty good resemblance. That's kind of why we named them that. So I think it was really cool, especially because not a lot of people name their dogs Coda, and I don't hear Kedai at all as a name. Sorry, my nose is like super stuffy because of all the crying. I don't ever hear Kenai as a name, and I don't ever hear Coda as a name, and Coda was like the cutest name ever, so we named them Kenai and Coda. It feels good to have them around and, you know, just be able to like acariciarlos, like basically like to be able to like show affection to them and just like take them in because they're so small, so we just kind of like scoop them up, and it's just, it's comforting. Tinkerbell is always going to be the number one in my heart, always. But it's super comforting to have a little piece of basically heaven on earth with you, because the little one reminds me so much of Tinkerbell. You know, Tinkerbell might have been a female and, you know, this one's a boy, but it just, they look the same, and it just brings me a little comfort. So now you guys are probably like, Tati, what the fuck happened to your eye? Let's just say iPhone 1, Tati 0. My phone corner, so literally like the corner of my phone, fell like right on the cheekbone portion of my eye, like right underneath my eye socket, like literally right there. It's where it fell. So you guys ever just lay on your bed and just like have your phone up like this and like it slips? So it slipped and it hit right here, but it hit so quick. Literally took 0.5 seconds for me to start crying. Seriously, like it was the worst thing ever. It first started getting purple, like a little bruise, and then it got made a bump, and then the next morning it just spread out to like this bruise. So no one hit me. I'd be damned if someone hit me, if I let someone hit me, like got me fucked up. Yeah, so this is kind of why I haven't filmed a tutorial. I was going to film a Valentine's Day tutorial, and I'm so mad because it literally hurts to even touch it right now. So like imagine like beating it with like a beauty blender, like that is just, it's a recipe for disaster. And I just think it sucks now because not only do I have the bruise, but before I had the bruise, I started developing like a rash right on the cheekbones of my face. And at first I didn't know what had caused them because, you know, like it's a rash and I don't ever get rashes. I don't have sensitive skin at all. I kind of just put two and two together, and I recently just got my hair dyed. I went back to ash blonde. You can't tell now because this is like post gym hair. Okay, but basically when the toner was sitting in my hair, I remember my hair like stuck to my face, and I was scared to touch it because I didn't have any gloves on and I didn't want it to stain anything on my hands. And it really explains why the rashes are literally right in the same spot on both sides. They're getting better now. They looked a lot worse, but I've been putting like hydrocortisone on it. I don't know, it's just, my life has just been like crumbling. Like life one, Tati zero. Look, I think it just kind of sucks because now I can't even like film like a Valentine's Day get ready with me, or like a Valentine's Day like look. It just sucks because I can't film any makeup tutorials until this at least clears up. The bruise might take a while, but you know, like all these little patches just need to clear up first, and then we're good to go. It feels good to be in front of the camera again, even if it's looking like this, or even if it's just talking about stuff that has nothing to do with makeup. Because, you know, at the end of the day, my channel is up for a makeup purpose and a lifestyle purpose. And this is part of the lifestyle. You have to go through things and grow through things. I like to think that I'm a super strong person for everything that I go through. For some people, it might not be a lot. For some people, it may be, like, the worst thing ever. To me, I'm just kind of passing through some bumps on the road right now. Losing a pet is something new to me, so I had never really experienced it. You know, I was always that person who scroll on Instagram and comment like, sorry for your loss, about like someone's pet. Until you actually go through it, you realize that it hurts like a family member, like you're losing a family member, especially if you've had them for so long. I've had Tinkerbell since I was 5 years old, as you guys can see from that clip a few minutes back that I showed you guys. I had her since I was 5. So it's like we grew up together. I had her before I had my sister, who is now going to be 15 in August. I just want to say that it feels so good to talk about this with you guys because I've been lagging on filming this video for the longest time ever. And I was just like, you know what? Like, I don't want to leave them in the dark. I just want to at least film this video to get it up to you guys so you guys know what's been going on and why I've been so distant and off the charts lately. I've been posting on my Twitter. I've been posting on my Snapchat. I've been posting on my Instagram. Not frequently, but I've been trying to get some content out there, especially because recently I've made it a priority to start hitting the gym like I used to be, 4 to 6 times a week working out. It's consistency is key, and I've been going to the gym and I've been really doing pretty good actually on my eating. I've always been a healthy eater, but I've been like swapping out new things here and there that I normally wouldn't be swapping out for healthy alternatives. So I've just been like kind of trying to find a balance in my life, and I think I need to start focusing on making YouTube kind of just one of those priorities because I really love being in front of the camera and talking to you guys and communicating with you guys, helping you guys out on tips and tricks for everything. So don't feel hesitant to comment down below and let me know what you guys like to see, what you guys don't like to see, what you guys want to see next, and I will happily get it out to you guys. Like I said, I've been going through a lot, so I know, I've said this before and I will say it again, I still need to put myself on a schedule for basically uploading, and like I said, lately I just have been out of it, and you guys can tell by my ojeras that I've been getting no sleep because having two puppies is like having two babies, and let me tell you, it is not easy. I wake up 3 times in the middle of the night to feed them and pick up their, you know, poos. The good thing is that they know, like, you know, to use the bathroom on like little poop pads, so that helps me a lot. I literally have been just, I've been kind of just there. Like, I haven't really been finding the need to like update anybody on anything I'm feeling or anything that I'm doing, and that's why I put myself in front of the camera right now, because I was like, you know what, I want to film this, I want to get it out to my subscribers, especially those who have been there since day one, because I don't want people to think that, oh, you know, like, I subscribed to her day one and now she's kind of just going MIA. Like, that's not the case. That is far from the case. But just let me know what you guys want to see next, and I really hope this helped you guys get some clarity on why I've been so absent and so distant and just so off the charts lately. So yeah, I promise you guys, I'm trying to slowly but surely get on a schedule, get on my grind, you know, start popping out looks here and there for new makeup tutorials and everything. Like I said, it's kind of hard now because I've just been going through it, but we will be back and we will be better than ever. So don't forget to subscribe down below if you're new, and also turn on the post. Here we go again. Turn on the bell icon so you'll be notified whenever I post new videos. Appreciate all the patience and with you guys bearing with me, and I will catch you guys in my next video.